the end of the day to get the statement that we wanted to. But I would like also to draw the parallel with the South African struggle. I remember back in the 80s, the 70s, when we were standing in the rain and people were ridiculing us. And Maggie Thatcher used to say, Nelson Mandela is a terrorist and will die in prison. I could have said to her, say wallahi, because he was freed and he was one of the best that Africa has produced, that the world has seen for many, many years. And I'd like also to say that having a statement is not just sufficient. That is the beginning of a very long road. And the most important thing is the BDS movement. What have brought South Africa to its senses was the BDS. The Africans were asking for boycotting South Africa, putting pressure on the government there, politicians, sports, everywhere. And that is how it was won at the end of the day. The Palestinians have also issued a call back in 2005. And actually not just the Palestinians, also civil groups, Israeli civil groups doing the same thing. And in 2006, the Israeli government established a ministry to combat the BDS because it's hurting them. They know that that could very well be the road for the dismantling, as many Israelis now are writing and saying, the decolonization of Israel. The decolonization of Israelis. Small, but effective, and they are coming for that.